So we started Brahma Samhita now, so at least we will remember these verses also, and there is a lot of meaning. So this is a famous verse, Ishwaraha Paramaha Krishna. Krishna is the Supreme Personality. In fact, you know, we had created this hierarchy of understanding for people. And the first level we used to say of Shraddhavan was that he chants Hare Krishna and he understands Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Beginning. This was somebody can understand means, you know, something is understood. And he, you know, slowly starts giving up all the four vices. So Ishwara Paramaha Krishna, the first step in spiritual understanding. And Prabhupada says the whole Vedic culture has collapsed because people have forgotten the position of Krishna. Even in the purports in Bhagavad Gita, again and again Prabhupada brings out this point that devadas are not on the platform of Krishna. Devadas are like sparks. Krishna is the sun. How can you compare it? They are also jivas like we are. And they have been blessed with a particular, you can say, responsibility. But we cannot, even in imagination, compare devata to Krishna. There are many controllers in this world. Everybody, artificially all of us, have come to this world. And alas, we are all trying to artificially occupy the position of an enjoyer. That is called Griha Pratha, who has taken this as a determination. Ambition in his life is to fulfill his nonsense fantasies. All of us have some nonsense fantasies, and whole life we waste in fulfilling those fantasies. Okay? So that is not it. Actually, Krishna is the enjoyer. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna also says, Sarvaloka Mahesha. I am the controller of it. Bhokta Ram Yagnatam Sam. I am the only enjoyer. Yes, Krishna is that personality. The original source of everything. Next, Satchidananda Vigraha. This is in one way the definition of Krishna, this whole shloka. Satchidananda, now he has a form, Vigraha. He is not formless. You know, some people have a mistaken idea that God, you know, I was seeing somebody saying, what benefit you get by praying? So they made a whole thing where they pray like this, a positive energy emanates from God. What is the nonsense possible? God is a person. What are you talking about this nonsense? For them, God is some power. Actually, they are a first-class atheist or something. But you know, they get cover of spirituality in that way. God has a form. Vigraha. And what kind of form? Satchidananda. Is it made of his bones and blood? No. It is made of Satchidananda. Sat means eternity. What's on the proper translation? Sat means comprising eternal existence. Sat means it is Satya. It has to be always a fact. This body is not Sat. It is Asat. Because after some time it is gone. But Krishna's body is eternally the same. Eternal. There is no temporary manifestation of the body. Chit, full of knowledge. Eternal knowledge. He knows everything eternally. It's like in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna tells Arjuna. What does he tell him? Krishna tells Arjuna, Arjuna, I taught this knowledge to sun god millions of years ago. Arjuna says, Krishna, what are you telling me? Millions of years ago, you are my contemporary. Krishna says, you were also there, Arjuna, but you don't remember. So Prabhupada says, because Krishna's form does not change. He has the same form eternally. Okay, so there is no difference between Krishna. Deha, Dehi, Abheda does not exist for Krishna. Krishna's form and Krishna, there is no difference. Sat, Satya, it is a fact. Some people consider Krishna died. How somebody can be more offensive than that? How can Krishna die? He is the Supreme Personality. It's just like the sun rises and the sun sets. It does not mean the sun has come into being at a particular time. No, sun was always there. But it becomes visible to us at a particular time. Similarly, Krishna becomes visible to us at a particular time, prakata lila. And the lila becomes aprakata after that. Krishna's lila is going on continuously. For a brief period, we also could peep into that lila. That is always going in the spiritual world. But Krishna manifested that in this world for us to watch and develop interest to join his pastimes. Okay? A pastime. Very unique. There are so many incarnations having pastime. But then, in those incarnations, our attachment to the Lord is with awe and reverence. But in Krishna, it's like Brahma, who offered this prayer, he also saw Krishna with a small boy, with some butter in his hand, something, and he's roaming around looking for the cows which he has already stolen. Ordinary boy, does not even look educated. And everybody says he is the Supreme Lord. Let me see more of his glorious pastime. He stole all the cow boys also. And then when Brahma came back after some time, in between there is Balaram, his brother, detects that people are getting so attached to children, their own children. Because actually what happened, the people stole. Brahma stole the cow boys and his calves. And then Krishna understood what has happened. But to convince, two reasons for that. Number one, which is more important, he wanted to give direct service to all the residents of Vrindavan, to him. The mothers of his friends had no opportunity to directly serve Krishna, so he wanted to give that opportunity. That was primary. That's why this whole thing, Brahma thing, he did that, but Brahma also Krishna used him for. And second thing was to convince Brahma, why Brahma, you should know my princess. And then what does Krishna do? He becomes all Vishnu forms. He takes and they take the particular form of all the boys and the calves. With the same nature, with the same habits, with the same dress, with the same attitude. Everybody is a unique person. Krishna took each one of those forms. And then for 1 year, nobody knew what's happening. Because parents, only thing what was happening was the attachment of the cows to their calves and attachment of the parents to the children started exploding. Previously, they were all attached to Krishna more than their own children. But now, they became equally attached to their own children. And Balaram saw this fun going on. He was wondering, what is all this? Must be some trick of Krishna. And then he inquired from Krishna, Krishna, this is something unusual going on here. Krishna revealed him, this is it. So this is Balaram, this is Brahma, what is he doing? Then Brahma actually, when they were talking like this, Brahma understood that it's getting late and he wanted to check up because he knows he's playing with somebody whom everybody says is the Supreme Lord. He wants to check up. What's happening? Let me go and see. And he was stuck. He has stolen those coward boys and calves and he has hidden somewhere, but they're all here. And then he went there and saw those coward boys. They're still sleeping there and here they're playing. So Brahma himself became now, his head was shaking, not understand. And then after that is over, Krishna, to convince Brahma what's happening, all those forms became Vishnu forms because they are finally expansion of Krishna as Vishnu. But Krishna is not incarnation of Vishnu, Krishna is avatari, not avatar. It's a mistake. He is the origin or even of Narayana or Vishnu. Krishna is not an incarnation. That is okay, not complete understanding. In one sense, there is no higher and lower because there is no difference between Krishna and Vishnu. It is the same person. But still, which is the original candle? When you light candles, so many candles, all candles have the same power. But still, there is one original candle. So as we study, scrutinizing the scripture, they reveal, actually Vishnu is not the origin. Krishna is the origin. People generally don't know that. They think Krishna is one of the expansions of Vishnu. It's incomplete. They have no idea about Goloka, even planet in Vaikuntha. Little, mostly people know little. They know about generally one Vaikuntha. They don't have understanding. There are unlimited Vaikuntha planet. There are so many Narayana forms there. And there is a Goloka planet where Krishna resides. Okay? Even Vaishnavas, their understanding is limited. So there what happens in this, and Brahma, after this, when it became Vishnu forms, all the, energies of the Lord for offering prayers to the Lord. all the energies in personified form, because everything is personified. All the 24 elements, each time, space, consciousness, everything is offering praise to the Vishnu consciousness. Correct? And Brahma is seeing this, what's happening, Narayana, with all beautiful features, and as being worshipped by all his energies, he is, well, now he is about to faint. He is not able to understand anything. And then Krishna wants to, poor fellow, he will faint. Krishna puts a yogamaya curtain so that partially he is also. And then Brahma then wonderstruck starts offering prayers. So that prayers and Brahma Samhita, there is no difference actually. Both are offering a praise of Brahma to Krishna. Glorification of Krishna. Prabhupada sometimes say there is a book scripture in the universe which is like Brahma Samhita. It's very advanced scripture. Conclusion. In fact, particularly for India, this scripture is very important, because here people have messed up between Devadas and Krishna. In this book, Brahma identified each of the Devata and their respective position to Krishna. He explains. He explains Devi as Chaya of Krishna. He explains Shiva position also. He explains Narayana position also. He explains Ganesha's position also. Everything is very clear. So it's very important actually for people in India to know the scripture so that they don't get misled. And this is the highest work, which is a thesis. Some devotee very rightly said, the PhD thesis of Brahma. That's like we have a thesis presentation. The thesis presentation. It's not the whole thing, because the whole thing is lost. Only this much is remaining. This is also few verses only. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to South India to Adi Keshava temple. He saw this scripture and he was very happy. The fifth chapter is remaining. Chaitanya immediately copied it and he was so happy to bring it with him. This is the Brahma Samhita. Eshwara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha. So there Brahma says, when I cannot understand the glories of Krishna, how can a common man understand? It's very difficult. It's full of eternity, full of knowledge and full of bliss. He is the source of the manifestation. He showed that. In his mouth, Krishna showed the whole universe to his mother. That means whole universe is within him. It's very small. So that is Krishna's position. Paramaha. They are all controllers. He is the supreme controller. He is a controller of even people like Brahma or Shiva or all the devas. He is the supreme controller. Now, men in this world, what happens? What everybody is wishing for, we are wishing for some material facility, immediate material facility for sense gratification, correct? People are haunted for that. And then they worship so-called political leaders, they do aarti for them, they do the puja for them, what they call a technical big guns of this world. And if they occupy a big post because of that, they feel very, very, very happy. So Krishna is not that kind, he is a supreme personality. And people, if you worship Krishna, you get a permanent benefit. You don't get this all temporary benefits. Prabhupada wants the Devata, even the benefits the Devata gave us, so temporary. All will vanish one day. It is just like an eternal time. These are like bubbles. Even Devata book, they come and they vanish. So we should not foolishly run after them. We always remember Sachidananda Vigraha. Our focus of attention has to be Krishna, not anything else. No need to distract ourselves anyway. Anadir Adi Govinda. You know, many times we have seen this question from some people. What is the question they say? They say, you say God is the origin. My question is, who is father of God? And they think they asked an intelligent question. It says, Anadi Adi. He is the origin, but he has no origin. Krishna is engaged in beautiful pastime, that's Govinda. In the spiritual world, Govinda is another name of Krishna. Engaged in the Goloka, engaged in beautiful pastimes. And Govinda means to give pleasure to the cows. Engaged in the cowherd boy in Goloka Vrindavana. In Vaikuntha doesn't happen. Vaikuntha is the Narayana. He is not taking care of cows in Vaikuntha. But in Goloka, he is taking care of the cows, he is busy. Govinda has many meanings. So Anadir Adir Govinda. In fact, Prabhupada most of the time named deities as Govinda. Most of the time. Radha Govinda. Therefore, we also and why we create, we just follow in Prabhupada's question of Govinda. Most of the deities we see Prabhupada kind name, maximum occurrence is of Govinda, Radha Govinda. So Anadir Adir Govinda, he is the origin of everything, Adi or Anadi. He does not have an origin. Very important verse. Anadi, Adi. He has an origin, but Anadi, he has no origin. Sarva Karana Karana. Why? Why is it so? Sarva Karana Karana. Prabhupada in the Bhagavatam also, when he begins, he says, we are not after just thinking about some tiny control of the world. We are looking for absolute truth, the cause of all causes. That is called absolute truth. We are related. Why we are related? Because we are caused by somebody. If we didn't exist, we could not have existed. We are related. But Krishna is absolute. He exists independent of anything in this world. He is already existing. It always exists. Eternally exists. That is called absolute truth. Sarva Karana Karana. Krishna is the cause of all. So this is the understanding that we get if we try to understand. And Prabhupada says that actually, if you want to understand Krishna, what does it says? Sarvopadevena muktam taratvaratvena nirmalam rishikena rishikesh sevana bhakti vachanam. We are engaged. You know? Devotional service to Krishna, many times some people say, bhakti is very easy actually. Yeah, this is all. But sir, anya vilashita shunyam jnana karmadi anavritam. That is called bhakti. If tell somebody the rules of jnana karmadi anavritam, you will faint. It's not easy to follow. But sometimes some people say, we are on jnana marga. You people simply taka taka play karta. You are on some simple process. Sir, if it is simple, why not follow it? Why you want to follow the difficult one? First answer. The second one, how to handle the jokers. The first one is that it's very simple. So why not follow the simple? The second thing is, it is not simple actually. And you want to offer pure bhakti to Krishna, you will get stunned. You cannot offer. Why? Jnana karma di anavritam. Karma refers to any activity. But here it refers to any activity for sense gratification, which is not for Krishna's pleasure. That is anavritam, free from that karma. Jnana, any kind of knowledgeable, trying to develop some knowledge or some understanding, again independent of Krishna, that is called jnana. There should be some connection finding it. Some way we connect. And then our knowledge is fine. Prabhupada says actually there can be no knowledge without understanding inconceivable feature of Krishna. There is no knowledge. The knowledge doesn't begin. If you want to begin in any field of knowledge, first thing, except inconceivable feature of Krishna. Just like you're studying teeth. And you begin with this. Inconceivable. How it is designed. My God. Yeah? People spend 10 years studying one teeth and they cannot fully understand how the teeth is functioning. Okay? How many years did they do graduation and post-graduation? After that you also ask him, do you definitely know all this? Actually no. That's all it is. And so we can find, so somewhere we have to start. Some people will say such a beautiful tree has come by an accident. No, don't say that. You say, what an inconceivable design of Krishna. Somewhere you have to attach inconceivable. They will say, no. Accidentally we were biting grass and then the teeth grew, something they will say. But it is more intelligent to say that Krishna's design is inconceivable. So beautiful Krishna can design. Okay. So this is one part. So this inconceivable feature of Krishna, when somebody understands, then only he becomes a devotee. Otherwise it is not easy to become a devotee. Okay. Unless you understand the inconceivable feature of Krishna. Become amazed. And then when you become abhay, Deva Bhagavad Gita also Krishna says what? He says, if you understand me as an origin, you will always worship me. What is the shloka? Chatur shloka, four shlokas of Gita, which is summary of the whole Bhagavad Gita. Huh? अहम सर्वस्य प्रभो वत्ता सर्वं प्रवर्तते इति वत्वा वदन्ते मां भूतभाव समर्पिता. सेम थिंग कृष्णा इज सेइंग. इफ यू अंडर सर्व कारण कारण इज द ओरिजिन एवरीथिंग. कृष्णा से अहम सर्वस्य प्रभो वहां आई एम द ओरिजिन एवरीथिंग. वत्ता सर्वं प्रवर्तते एवरीथिंग इज कमिंग आउट ऑफ इति वत्वा वदन्ते मां. इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस भजन्ते मां डिवोशन भूतभाव समर्पिता. सेम थिंग हियर इज गोइंग. Ishara Paramagi, the supreme controller, he is the origin of everything. If we get convinced of this, then only we can advance. In fact, that's what bhakti is called. Anukulena Krishna Anusilana. First you have to become free from jnana and karma. If you are still attracted to jnana and karma, you cannot offer pure devotional service to Krishna. You cannot. It's not possible. You're still we are attracted to some fantasies of the mind, either gross or subtle. Where is what you offer? The mind is still running behind that. Correct? So mind has to be free from that. Evam prasanna manaso. When mind is free from all these hankerings, then only it becomes joyful. When mind is being pushed and harassed of material fantasies that we have created foolishly, where is joyfulness of the mind? Not possible. So when mind is free from these fantasies, self, Bhaksanda Prabhupada says, self-inflicted inconvenient condition we have created for ourselves. Self-inflicted. This completely unwanted situation that we created for ourselves in the material world is self-inflicted. It's not that Krishna sent us to this world. Foolishly we have done this and we have brought ourselves in this horrible condition. That is our condition. Right? This is self-inflicted, this position. So sarva karana karana, Krishna is the cause of everything. In fact, so anukulena, we have to, Bhaksanda Prabhupada is the nice word, but you are very kind to Krishna. In the sense, kind not doing a favor, it's trying that to participate in Krishna's enjoyment. It's like somebody is kind to somebody, means he wants to supply. It's like a mother is kind to the child, what do they do? They keep supplying material for the child's enjoyment. Correct? Continuously. Mother may not eat, but she will be happy to keep supplying things, whatever possible, for the child's enjoyment. The same way, where is this originating? Same thing is actually to apply in purity to Krishna. To supply out the whole life, child will not be satisfied. It's like Gandhi. He tried to sacrifice his life for the country, shot him dead. Not satisfied, sir. That's the meaning. Similarly, if you think your life success will supply the child, one day you will get a slap on your face. If a child will not be satisfied, you cannot anyway materially satisfy an individual. You are wasting your life over them. You are becoming mad actually. That's called madness. Like morning I was talking about Bharat Maharaj. The small deer came. He got involved with the deer. Then leave the deer on his own life. No, it's going on. Then what is the result? Result, he has to take birth in this world. He has to repeat the birth in this world. He should not get attached. Okay, some care, and then now everybody will run around by his own karma. What can we do? We should not get overly attached. That is a mistake in this world. So, sarvakasa supply is that anukulena, the feature is actually not for this world. That feature is for Krishna. He will be. Anukulena, not like Kamsa who wanted to kill Krishna. Favorably, how do I please Krishna? Because Krishna is enjoyed. And artificially, unfortunately, we have taken the position as enjoyed. Everything in this world belongs to Krishna. How can he enjoy? He cannot enjoy. Correct? If somebody is dependent on us also, we should teach him first this thing. Sir, anything you are seeing, you are not the enjoyer. Krishna is enjoyed. You are not the enjoyer. That is the first training. Krishna is the enjoyer of everything. And therefore a house should be like a temple. Every activity is done for Krishna's pleasure. That is called Grihastha. When activity is done for our pleasure, that is called Griha Medhi. And Griha Vrata. That is foolishness. Animal life. Animals also live together. That doesn't become something divine. Similarly, if that objective is lost, anyway, it's gone. It gets best for me.
So Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada says very strongly that he says, if we are not engaged in Hari Bhajana and service to Krishna, we cannot pick up a blade of grass also in this world. We have no right to touch even a blade of grass in this world. We have no right. He was very strong in his word. You understood? He says, you do not have a right to pick up even a blade of grass in this world if you are not engaged in Hari Bhajana. Why? Because everything in this world belongs to Hari. For Hari Bhajana, you can pick up anything. Correct? It's like this kartal, is it? Now if you pick up this kartal and start singing your own glories, or even Devata glories, like Narada was cursed to become the boy, a son of a maidservant. Why? Because previous life he was singing Devata glories. Cursed. He was cursed by Devata itself. What is the nonsense here? Oh. He was made a Shudra. Correct? It's considered foolishness. So similarly, people don't understand this fact actually. Nothing in this whole universe belongs to us. It belongs to Krishna. If something belongs to somebody, it should be used for his pleasure. It's common sense. This doesn't require much intelligence. The same way, not a blade of grass in this world belongs to us. Correct? They should be used for Krishna's pleasure. And just by, you know, wearing a dress, it doesn't happen. And whole consciousness has to change. Whole consciousness has to change from, you know, this grihavarta to grihastha, from bhogi to yogi. The whole consciousness change, and which is the subject matter here. Okay, so Ishvara, Parama, Krishna, Krishna is Supreme Personality, Sachidananda Vigraha, and he is eternal, chit is full of knowledge, full of bliss, Anadi Radhe Govinda, he is the origin of everything, Anadi. Anadi, but he has no other origin. His other name is Govinda, and Sarva Karana Karana, he is the cause of everything. So this is a meditation we should all try to develop. Then we will advance in Krishna consciousness. And there is a lot of description he gives, Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada, even Brahma gives, about Krishna's beauty. Krishna is very, very pure. His color is like a new rain cloud. That is Krishna's color, cloud with water, new rain cloud. And if we are not seeing Krishna, but Prabhupada explains, he says that in this world, fair is considered good, correct? Generally, girls, fair means best. But Krishna's color is bluish, and it is much more beautiful than the dull white color of this world that we have to see. We have no facility to see, we are hearing from an acharya. It's very good. And his eyes, his whole senses, his form is amazingly beautiful. Krishna is too beautiful. That is his vigraha, and that we are meditating upon. And that is the personality of Krishna. And the other manifestations, in fact, to complete, Sachidananda also refers to other manifestations. Sat refers, therefore he uses the word enumbra. You know, this is like an English dictionary we have to use to get one by one out of this word. It's mainly a penumbra. Penumbra or umbra, both the words, they originate basically like a shadow. The original Krishna's personality is what Brahma saw in Vrindavan, holding a butter and unimaginably beautiful figure of Krishna. But at the same time, a reflection or a shadow of his is, you know, this. Two features. One of the features is Brahman feature, which just represents Krishna's effulgence. That is Sat, eternal. Brahman is souls, eternally existing souls. That represents the eternity of Krishna. And we are in existence today, we are Asat. We are in a temporary future. Any time, our life ends. And therefore, we are in constant anxiety. We have a world of fantasy.
but we are in constant anxiety in that, because all before we fulfill the fantasies.